With a number of our AX 2012 projects either completed or underway, one of the questions that's been coming back is in relation to how best do we go through and turn off unwanted functionality? And really the answer lies in between managing the license codes, the license configuration, and end user security. Now really the first place to start is the license codes themselves. This is a great place to go and turn off broad functionality that's no longer required. So this would be things such as the industry solutions. Here really it's as easy as going into the license information form and line by line going and removing the license codes that are no longer required. So things such as public sector, retail back office. Now for those that have implemented AX or configured AX for a while, this will seem a little unnatural compared to things in the past. Second, in terms of license configuration, this is really a place to come in and fine-tune some of, you know, what remains in terms of functionality. So this would be things like removing currency code, for example. And finally, there's user security. The nice part about user security is here's where we can come and actually remove a lot of the unwanted noise that users don't want to see. Now, this is both easy and hard in AX 2012. Easy because there's a number of out-of-the-box roles that will help enable this, but hard because now it's a little bit more onerous, as well as development is required to kind of take that to the next level and implement that. Now, on your project, it's really going to vary greatly depending on what you need to do in terms of managing the license codes, configuration, and end user security. But remember, at the end of the day, this is an ERP system, and making changes and removing codes may have unwanted or at least unexpected consequences. So remember, at the end of the day, test, test, test.